K-pop's success has always been measured by its international fan base, with big concerts and high views on YouTube. However, it turns out that there has also been significant export volume growth. This means more and more overseas fans are streaming South Korean music through local streaming services. Kim Do-yeon explains.
2021 is already the best ever year for South Korea's music exports. According to the Korea Customs Service, the volume of exports stood at nearly 190 million U.S. dollars by October, already surpassing last year's record 136 million U.S. dollars. At this rate, the export volume could even surpass the 200 million mark, when it was only last year that the 100 million mark was topped. Japan was the biggest customer among destination countries, with China and U.S. following on the list. The most notable increase was the U.S. market. In 2012, the U.S. share of export volume stood at 2.2%, now it's above 17%. This indicates that more people overseas are streaming K-pop music through local streaming services. Just looking at the charts this year, K-pop sensation BTS topped Billboard's Hot 100 for 10 weeks with Butter. The group's Permission to Dance and My Universe also spent time at number 1. Girl groups added to the volume by placing high on album charts. Blackpink had an album reach the number 2 spot on the Billboard 200 for the first time, while TWICE and ITZY took 3rd and 11th place positions in the charts respectively during the year. But South Korean music distribution companies say there are many more artists outside of the mainstream that receive a lot of demand on streaming services. In fact, according to reports, one such distributor, Genie, said its profits grew from around $10 million in 2019 to nearly $18 million in 2020. Considering big names like BTS or Blackpink do not use these companies and only smaller labels distribute this way, it shows that more stars are in line for future recognition. Kim Do-yeon, Arirang News.